Thanks so much for having me. My name is Fred King, and today I'm going to give a keynote that's an introduction to the future of blockchain tech. The full title is The Future of Blockchain Tech 2035. But before I start, a quick disclaimer. I'm giving this keynote for educational purposes only. The projects I'll mention are not affiliated with me. Nothing here is sponsored. I'll highlight certain projects simply because they're pushing the envelope. Today I'll focus on just four areas for improvement, four areas related to my personal experience. So let's begin. First up, banking. According to the Central Bank of the Philippines, around 27 million adults in the Philippines don't have bank accounts. At the same time, around 87% of those unbanked individuals have smartphones and access to the internet. Well, I have some good news for those people. By 2035, traditional bank accounts may be a thing of the past. Imagine a future where centralized checking and savings accounts are gone, replaced by self-custodial wallets. No more unbanked regions. All you need is a smartphone. No paperwork, no credit score, and no bias based on skin color, gender, age, or faith. Everyone's equal and part of one global ecosystem. Banks are biased and full of hidden rules. We need a future where people from remote villages to city centers have equal access to global financial tools. And this future is already starting to take shape. As some of you may know, I've reviewed dozens of hardware and software wallets on my YouTube channel, CryptoSnake. I've seen progress from slow and expensive wallet-to-wallet transactions to instant crypto payments using Visa or MasterCard. And one of the most innovative solutions, in my opinion, that combines hardware wallet-level security with the ease of a debit card is Tangem Pay. Tangem Pay is the first self-custodial Visa card with a cold wallet chip. You own 100% of your funds. All you need is to pick which stablecoin or crypto you want to use for payments. Plus, you can stake your crypto inside a cold wallet, which is much better, in my opinion, than keeping cash in a savings account. As you can see, the tools to go bank-free are already here, but adoption takes time. Over the next decade, we all, as a blockchain community, will focus on making these solutions global. Next up, RWAs. Real-world assets. Back in 2018, when I lived in Silicon Valley, tokenization of assets was a new cool concept. I'm a software developer, and back in the day, I was helping a project called Propy. Propy was the first company that started using the term tokenized real estate. But at the time, it was nothing but an idea, a good idea. Same idea as tokenized gold, tokenized company shares, and even tokenized social media profiles. And speaking of social media profiles, I remember creating a profile on DSO, Decentralized Social. Some people were even buying my social media tokens. But these were all just cool concepts and ideas for crypto bros, not a mainstream thing. Over the years, tokenization of social media profiles, NFT JPEGs, and other empty things with no real value faded out. However, tokenization of real assets with real value became a hot topic, and for good reason, because the world needs it. When you tokenize real assets, like real estate, US Treasury bills, precious metals, or anything else with value, you unlock the benefits of blockchain. Tokenized assets can be split into tiny pieces, used as collateral for DeFi loans, or plugged into yield strategies. I know a lot of people who want to diversify their portfolios but don't have enough money to buy a house. With tokenized real estate, you can own a small piece of a hotel here in Manila or a tiny slice of a luxury apartment in Manhattan. Some industry experts say that within the next 5 years, most real-world assets could be tokenized. By 2035, we might be living in a world where almost everything is tokenized, and almost everyone holds digital ownership of their assets on the blockchain. Here's a fun example. Imagine it's 2035 and you own a $50 slice of a Miami apartment. One token representing a tiny share of the deed. Rent shows up in your wallet each month. That could be awesome. But the numbers speak louder. I asked ChatGPT to name two leaders in RWA tokenization, and it pointed to Securitize and Centrifuge. Securitize has already tokenized about $4 billion worth of assets, helping big players like BlackRock and KKR put their fund shares on chain, so qualified investors can buy digital tokens instead of paper certificates. And Centrifuge, on the other hand, is an asset agnostic platform. You can tokenize any asset class with no restrictions. So far, it has financed around $1 billion worth of assets. There are many other companies, and we're talking about billions now. We already live in a digital world where DocuSign is the norm. The shift from handwritten signatures to electronic signatures was smooth and painless. And we save a lot of trees now by not using paper. Tokenization of assets is the next logical step in a digital world. And by 2035, it might feel just as normal as clicking sign online. Think of it, the largest asset management company in the world, BlackRock, is already all in. So the next decade looks very promising. Now let's talk about the entertainment sector. As a creator myself, this topic means a lot to me. Many of you have heard stories about YouTube channels being removed and musicians suing labels over unpaid royalties. I've got my own stories. As a crypto YouTuber, sometimes I deal with censorship. Sometimes my videos lose indexation because crypto, for some reason, is still a sensitive topic on YouTube. On the music side, I have some experience too. I have a side project called Music Snake. Yeah, I love writing songs when I have some free time. And as a part-time independent musician, I get way lower royalties compared to labels. I'm talking about rates, CPMs, way lower. Plus, I don't get access to editorial playlists. Right now, just three major labels, Universal, Sony, and Warner, control around 70% of the music business. And on the video side, YouTube basically has built a monopoly. This might finally change by 2035. Blockchain transparency powered by AI fraud detection could make every video view or song play instantly send small payments straight to the copyright holders. Blockchain is neutral by design, protecting free speech and enforcing fair rules for content around the world. People talked about decentralized platforms back in 2017, but because of things like regulations, copyright issues, and stream manipulations, it never really took off. Maybe it will never take off in the future either. But now, with the new friendly regulatory environment and everything moving fast on the AI side, that future for content creators is finally starting to look real. Now let's talk about the project. On the video side, we have Odysee. Odysee is a decentralized video platform that gives creators more control over their content and reduces the risk of censorship. On Odysee, creators can monetize their videos directly without needing any middleman. It's not a concept anymore, the project is growing. Right now, the platform has about 17 million unique monthly visitors. A fun fact, Odysee's X account is followed by Joe Rogan, which gives me hope that at some point, huge influencers will join the blockchain movement. For those who don't know, Joe Rogan is a very popular American podcaster. On the audio side, the most prominent blockchain project is Audius. Audius is a decentralized music streaming platform that connects artists and fans directly. You don't need any music distributors. It uses blockchain technology to enable fair and transparent compensation for artists. Right now, the platform is supporting over 700,000 musicians and has about 7 million monthly listeners. Platforms like YouTube, Spotify, and Apple Music still have a lot of problems, especially with bias policies. If platforms like Audius and Odysee keep growing, it's only a matter of time before YouTube, Spotify, and Apple Music are forced to adapt. There is clearly a huge demand for blockchain-powered music and video platforms that apply fair rules equally to everyone. So over the next decade, we'll need to educate both creators and fans about decentralization and true content ownership. The final area for improvement I'll talk about today is super important and pretty obvious, the global economy. You may ask, what personal story do you have on this subject? Well, I'm sharing my perspective as a Bitcoiner who's been watching the industry since 2015. Actually, I got introduced to Bitcoin back in 2012, but at the time it didn't sound too serious to me, unfortunately. As someone with Eastern European roots, I was born in Belarus. I instantly labeled Bitcoin a scam, just like many others did. Even Michael Saylor compared it to online gambling back in the day. Anyway, for the past decade, for the past 10 years, I studied Bitcoin, invested in Bitcoin, attended multiple Bitcoin events, spoke with politicians, entrepreneurs, influencers, and saw both the vice president and the president of the United States speak at the Bitcoin conference. Guys, we went from Bitcoin being tagged as a scam for drug dealers to Bitcoin becoming the US strategic reserve asset. What a time to be alive. And my observations over the past decade led to a very obvious, logical, and now very popular conclusion that keeps getting repeated. Bitcoin is much better than gold and is shaping up to become the world's top reserve asset. Let's quickly recap a few key facts about Bitcoin. You all know them. Bitcoin was created by an anonymous person, a group of people. It's kept at 21 million coins, has the largest market cap among all blockchain assets, and isn't controlled by any government or central authority. For the past 16 years, Bitcoin has proven itself as the best hedge against inflation, the best store of value, earning the nickname Gold 2.0. And speaking of gold, do we actually know how much gold the US has in its vaults? That's a rhetorical question. We don't know. The last time Fort Knox was fully audited, not partially, fully audited, it was in 1953. 1953, over 70 years ago. Most gold today is owned and traded on paper. It's heavy, hard to move around, not easily divisible, and difficult to verify. Verifying just one gold bar can take about 7 minutes. And if you wanted to verify $1 billion worth of gold, you'd need somewhere between 85 and 100 man hours. And specialized equipment. And speaking of supply, we have absolutely no idea how much more gold is still left to mine here on Earth. Who knows, maybe in 10 years we'll even find gold on Mars. Gold supply is unpredictable, unlike Bitcoin, which is forever locked at 21 million coins. Plus, those Bitcoins can't be recovered. As a physical asset that's mostly traded on paper, gold doesn't stand a chance at keeping its position as the number one commodity in an AI-driven future. And that's exactly why year after year, we're seeing more and more countries gradually shifting toward a Bitcoin standard. The United States, the world's number one economy, is becoming increasingly Bitcoin-friendly. El Salvador already made Bitcoin legal tender, and several other countries now hold Bitcoin on their balance sheets. By 2035, Bitcoin could become the backbone of the global economy. Anyone could just open an app or ask an AI assistant to quickly check a country's financial health. In a future where countries keep Bitcoin as their reserve asset and use stablecoins instead of cash, economies would become fully transparent. We'd be able to instantly see the total reserves, debt levels, and capital flows of every single country that adopts blockchain philosophy. By 2035, Bitcoin has a real chance to surpass gold in terms of market cap. Just look at the progress we've made over the past 16 years. The next decade looks even more entertaining. At the end of my speech, I want to say this. What pulled me into blockchain was its core principles. It gives everyone equal opportunities. The blockchain community is one of the most freedom-oriented communities out there, and freedom drives progress. With the help of blockchain, by 2035, we might be living in a world where everyone has equal access to global financial tools. A digital world where real assets are fully tokenized. A decentralized world where the media giants no longer control the entire entertainment sector. And a world where the global economy is fully transparent, blockchain gives us freedom and transparency. And that's exactly why it has a bright future. We are still very early. Thank you.